drowning in the argument, the anti-white says. What exactly is anti-white? You have got to be animated with the righteous passion of reclaiming our destiny. We are the heroes of this era.
Well, it looks like we're going to have a cozy little stream here. Not on Cozy, of course, but on all of the other platforms. Great to see everybody who decided to show up. Let me pour myself some water. We're going to have a look at this documentary that was expose done on Patriotic Alternative. We just wrapped up there. And folks are talking about it. We're going to give our opinion on it. I might play some music quietly in the background just to help with potential claims that this Channel 4 could make against me and this channel. So you all will have to work with me in the beginning. Please grab the URL and share it.
This channel.
Let me do this. Entropy is up. That's what you just heard, if you heard it. Share the URL, see if we can find a few more people to come in and listen to this documentary. We want folks to know what's going on over there, what the anti-whites are up to and how they operate. These are important topics. Can everybody hear me? If so, then we'll get ready here to roll. As is always the case, we have Entropy up and rolling. We have DLive. We have Odyssey. You can financially gift on Odyssey. You may financially gift on Entropy. Also at Cash App. Cash App is no cost. It's a app you have to download. And you can find the link in the description below. And I think also on, what is this other one called? What is that platform? It's something, I know it's Rumble. That's what it is. And so we have that up as well. Though I don't know if anybody can financially gift there. They charge 20%, I think, to you to financially gift. So let me make sure that this is up. We just wrapped up on PWR. We had Barkley on. He's featured. And I think he might be the hero. I think even at his young years, I think he might be the hero of the documentary. You'll see why. We also had Sam Melia and, of course, Mark Hollett over there. So let me bring up the video.
Far right is changing.
All right. So there are closed captions at the bottom. If you all can make any sense of them, it looks like they're two different sets of closed captions. So let's see if we can get this music on quietly in the background. Could you hear her? I think that's probably, should I lower that music? Can you all hear that? We'll decide what we should do. If you have any questions or comments, please chime in. Maybe you see something like, oh yeah, that's exactly the way things should be done. Or, oh my gosh, they should have been watching for this. Or they should have watched for that. Or whatever it might be. Or maybe you think a contrarian position. Maybe you have a contrarian position and they should have absolutely done something that we would consider to be antithetical and objectionable. Can people hear this? Glenn says to lower it, please. See about how about that? Can the people hear? One of Western Kind says, I like the chillaxing tune. Howard is here. Great to see you. Artificer, Aethelwolf, Bane, Nancy Drew. And who else do we have? Dr. Lawson. There's Little Ladybug. How are you, young lady? Nice to see you. And the Rory, the gentleman Herbert is with us. So's Colt. And who else is? Jilly is here. Doubleheader again. Yes. Dan is with us. And did I name you Nancy? Yes, I did. Never felt guilty. Jay is here as well. Thank you all for coming over. I appreciate that. Lemon and lime. Sound is good. Okay. Will says the sound is good. The Highlander. All right. Thank you all for the feedback. Now you all know what we're talking about here. This is a Channel 4 in the UK documentary expose that was done on the Patriotic Alternative because the anti-whites run the mainstream media. And so they want to demonize Patriotic Alternative, of course, headed up by Mark Collett, is slowly and steadily growing and attracting normal folks, our normal brothers and sisters over there in the UK. And those are the best kind. So let's see if you can hear this woman and you can hear the participants in this expose over top of the music just fine. If there is a problem with that, then we can maybe lower the music a little bit. Let me have that feedback, and we will stay on. So essentially, to set the table, you have somebody who was inserted, and this would have been many, many thousands of dollars because they were there for many, many months. They had a house to live in and a bank account and everything so that they could give this information to the PA leadership, and they could confirm this is a real person. And this was a person who gave his real identity, was really an undercover reporter all along. And this is something that happens, and it's a pretty regular thing. It's often a reporter. It can very as well often be from one of these anti-white non-governmental organizations. They insert to incite, they insert to glean information, they insert for expose, they insert to get you to commit some sort of illegality, they insert to get people encouraging you to behave like the villain if you're not behaving like the villain, because they know they've already taught the population what the villain in the anti-white narrative believes, all the things they believe. And if they can, they know the anti-white, if they can get you to just say one or two things that matches their villain role in the narrative, then they know that when they show that to our brothers and sisters out there, our brothers and sisters will see all of those horrible things that the villain believes, even though you or the person who is saying these things or the group, the one or two things that matches the villain role, they don't believe any of the rest of it. It doesn't matter. You won't be able to make your case. That's how the anti-whites operate. Let's roll.
Exploiting COVID-19.
The COVID narrative was sold to us for two reasons.
Let me open up a screen over on YouTube to see if I'm getting any sort of a warning to shut down. It is astounding what we're
power
up against.
And profit.
All right, now that is, as the owner of this channel, I'm just gonna say, these are not my opinions. In the documentary, I'm reviewing this. And I would imagine that if Mark was given more opportunity to expound on that, he would include some other things in the motivation there.
And seizing on the culture wars.
And it's like, you know, that's all I'm fucking with. No kneeling.
So they've written on the screen here what they're saying. I can't quite. Can you all understand them? Is the sound loud enough for you all?
Dispatches is going undercover in Britain's new far right.
There's Sam.
We infiltrate a growing movement that's sparking clashes on the streets.
Okay, now that is typical, despicable anti-white misdirection and propaganda. PA is not sparking clashes on the street in any way, shape, or form. But this is what the anti-whites do. These are anti-white thugs, masked up thugs that have come out to physically assault, intimidate, frighten, maim people who object or get in the way in any way, shape, or form to anti-white doctrine and the objective of inflicting injury on Western kind. They want to intimidate you out of doing this. Now, did those dispatch, this Channel 4, whatever it is, did they or did one of the people participating actually tip off? Did they actually call up these anti-whites in the streets and say, hey, they're going to be out there. Our man's going to be out there. And while he's out there, I want you to attack the group. And of course, it does appear that this guy may not have known, or maybe he did. And maybe that's why he was so quick, this undercover guy. Maybe that's why he was so quick to immediately say, don't beat me up. I'm an undercover reporter. Regrettably, of course, Sam didn't hear this. Laura didn't hear this when this guy ran away saying, don't beat me up. Which, by the way, folks, also demonstrates that there is this infernal bond between the anti-whites in the seats and the anti-whites in the streets. They know when they demonize and dehumanize somebody, think about this, that when they dehumanize somebody because they're in the way of anti-whites inflicting injury on Western kind, Western civilization, they know that anti-whites like these bastards here with the masks on, that they're going to head out and bludgeon them to death. And these people, these reporters and the anti-whites in government, they laugh it up. That's exactly what they want to have happen. So it's not this game of, well, we don't know exactly what's going on. But if I had to put money down, I don't know for sure, but if I had to put money down, I would say a producer, co-producer, somebody over there behind this expose tipped off these anti-whites in the streets to make sure they would have footage that they could then later say, they do two things with. Silently, they intimidate people, good white people, out of participating because they think, if I participate, I'm just going to get physically attacked when I walk down the street. People are scared of that. It's going to cause the women of the men who decide to participate to object and to nag them and to bitch and to throw tantrums until the man decides not to go. What are you? You're going to go out there and you're going to deliver leaflets for what? And then your head's going to get broken. And who's going to pay little Johnny and little Susie to eat when you can't go to work anymore while you're recovering? Don't go to that. And then, you know, denying him other things as women are wont to do when they want to get their way. So there is that. And then you have the opportunity of the teen here at Channel 4 to say, well, look at all the violence that PA is causing in the streets.
Yeah, I've been attacked. Some guys with masks on.
Interfering with democracy.
We had a concerted and deliberate attempt to intervene illegally in the election.
So there you have it. Interfering with democracy. And of course, democracy here is a meme pathogen, meaning interfering with anti-whiteism. Of course, they're not going to call it anti-whiteism, but you have to. And you're going to see a major victory in this expose. It's the major victories all around, but there is a very profound victory.
And recruiting the next generation.
I watched a meme compilation. That is what led me.
What was that? Let's go back. How can I? Let's see if this. Does that jump like this? No.
The next generation.
I watched a meme compilation. That is what led me to being at Canto with some of the most notorious neo-Nazis in the country.
I know, right?
I would describe patriotic alternative.
Yeah, regrettably, I can't quite make out some of what's being said. But if you all know what was being said, then you might be might help me out by quoting it in the live chat.
As a fascist,
that was Barclay.
Organization who are engaged in what I call hateful extremism.
The enemy within, my God. All right, so these are anti-whites in the streets. Well, the subtitles are wretched, aren't they?
The murder of George Floyd prompted unprecedented protests around the world.
So that, I want you to pay attention to that reality. An individual died. Did they call it murder? Was that the finding in court? Or was it some sort of manslaughter But I guess, you know, when anti-whites are talking on television, it just, truth doesn't matter whatsoever. So, but we'll leave it up to the court and CNN to tell you exactly what the conclusion was, I guess we should say. But notice this, that this is a singular ideology, Western civilization over, such that you get the same response around the world from the population. The beauty of that is, it tells you, of course, that anti-whiteism is a singular entity. The beauty of that is that it needs only one cure. One cure that corrects it anywhere will correct it everywhere. We have that cure with Going Free.
Activism swept across social media feeds.
Another thing I want to point out really quickly is that all of these people are motivated by the fiction of violence on non-white individuals. Of course, the evidence demonstrates that this does not exist, but you'll have to ask CNN, according to some. So I'm just here for entertainment purposes. But according to some, there isn't this wave of violence against non-white people and this discrimination, persecution, etc. But it exists. It is ubiquitous in entertainment. It is ubiquitous in movies, sitcoms, etc. That's why all those people have shown up out in the streets. You need to understand that the subconscious mind doesn't know the difference. These people are not showing up for the shit of it, right? You need to understand that the subconscious mind doesn't know the difference between reality and fiction. And that's why these people will travel even hundreds of miles to come out and froth at the mouth like this.
But so did the backlash.
The rise of Black Lives Matter allowed the far right to kind of assert a white identity.
You see here a wonderful thing, that this misattribution by this anti-white. So let them continue to try to frame things that way.
In a way that they hadn't done for several years.
The reason why these people from BLM are rioting is because they're anti-white. It's as simple as...
Oh, I love it! We have Laura and we have Barkley, both using lexicon and winning.
There's one group whose loud assertion of a white identity stands out. Patriotic Alternative, or PA for short, only launched in 2019. But they've since established regional groups across Britain, claiming up to 240 activists ranks each month. During lockdown, their content attracts tens of thousands of views.
Just as an aside, look at how gorgeous that countryside is.
Certainly, Patriotic Alternative is the biggest far-right organization in the UK at the moment.
All right, so the biggest organization. And isn't it nice, they always want to frame it by saying, oh, it's the far right. This, we got to get out of their narrative. We're not in their narrative. What is this?
If we look back, you had to be hard to be on the far right, which of course excluded.
Okay, so this, in other words, this is not PA. So they've had to go find footage from something else, somewhere else. Misrepresenting.
Quite a lot of people. Increasingly what we're seeing now is the emergence of a more online...
So you can see how just dishonest these anti-white bastards are. And look at this guy, just an absolute picture of health and muscle. This is your anti-white, sitting behind the keyboard, talking to your employer, talking to your principal.
Based younger, more tech-savvy far-right.
So they're making it sound there like, oh, they're targeting young people because they're trying to just pollute them. Oh, but no, you're not targeting the young people when you want to get to them with conversations about what they want to have sex with or what sex they might be, or at the earliest of ages. No, that's not targeting. But telling them to love their people and love their country and love their history, that's targeting. That tells you everything. If you're Channel 4 watcher and you weren't already despising anti-whiteism, now's the time.
Dispatches is going undercover to infiltrate Patriotic Alternative.
Infiltrate. Like it's some sort of scary thing. Unfortunately, since we have this music playing, I don't know if that we'll be able to hear their music.
We
you know
began
they play
in 2020,
evil music.
But have been unable to broadcast until now. To get a foothold in the group, our undercover reporter, who we're calling Elliot, has to appear convincing.
Is that really him? Is that he's a neckbeard? Is that him? Does anybody know? He's a neckbeard? Oh, well, this is one of the things, and we just mentioned this on PWR. This is why I have argued for so long, two decades, that we need to be who we are in our hearts. We love with every one of our acts. And it's the deepest and most profound love to ever exist, because we are standing up for Western kind, white well-being. We're standing up for white well-being. In an age when anti-white bastards like this have the ability to get into everybody's intimate spaces, their living rooms, their studies, their family rooms, in their car with them, right in the cockpit of the car with them, and tell them how evil we are and for feeling this way, and tell them misrepresentations about us, what all the other things that we think about. So you never want to play the villain, ever. You never want to imitate what they want you to be. There's nothing, when people say today, when they say it's so true, they use edgy as a euphemism for playing the villain. You can be edgy by standing up for white well-being. And I give this example. Go down to the mall, go down to the city center and start yelling that white people deserve white well-being and that you're standing up for white well-being. And that you are opposed the discrimination against whites. Did you oppose? You go ahead and try that and see if you don't get as much ire from the frothing anti-white mutts out there, the pigs out there. You see if you don't get as much hatred from them, if not more, than if you went out and you said some sort of racial epithet. You go ahead and try. Everybody who thinks that that's not the case, go ahead and try and see what happens. You're going to get at least as much, if not more, for saying that you're going to stand up for Western kind. That, my friends, then is the genuine definition of edgy. You're not going to be able to get away with, oh, I was just joking with playing the villain. Only people who are millionaires can get away with that.
He begins by taking part in PA's White Lives Matter campaign. The campaign marks World Indigenous Peoples Day, a UN event intended to protect those communities.
Okay, so you see here the exclusion of Western kind from protection. I mean, very, very clearly, it's just non-white people to protect non-white people. When they say indigenous community, what non-white group do they exclude from that? It's none. This is just another arguments, another meme pathogen, another excuse to be anti-white. To protect them, what are the actions of the protection? Who are you defending them from? Ergo, who is the bad guy? Children, white kids in fifth grade, fourth grade can figure out that they're the bad guys. If the non-white people around the world have to be protected, there's somebody they have to be protected from, must be my people. Painted as the bad. That's what we talk about then. And then how do you get back? Well, if you're the bad guys and we're having to protect the non-whites from you, then what now do you owe them? What? How are you going to make amends? That's the premise of their argument. Talk about that rather than, boy, that's a stupid head cover or whatever it might be.
An event PA co-opts, claiming it's white Britons who are under threat.
White people are victims. We're doing this because we're victimized.
Laura looked wonderful there, didn't she?
PA paint an existential threat two white communities and where they really call for radical action in order to counteract those developments.
Radical action, another misrepresentation, because that the implication there is violence. That's the radical action. Here's another thing that has to be said right here at the beginning, and that is that, back to the point about being who we really are in our hearts, love, hope, and redemption, and service to white well-being, to put an end to anti-whiteism, which is destroying Western civilization, white erasing us from our civilization, biologically white erasing us. We need to be aware that anti-whites are always going to be inserted this way. They're always going to be listening. They're always going to be observing. There's no opportunity to say, oh, it's just satire. You can, the only group that you can satirize are white people. That's it. You can tell Polish jokes. You can tell blonde jokes. You can make fun of white men all day long. You can tell jokes about Italians. You can tell jokes about all these. That's it. You can't say, you can't rely on, well, I should be able to tell this jokes about, no, who gives a shit what you think about what you should be able to say? Deal with the world, deal with our reality.
The great replacement theory is at the heart of PAs.
I recommend not to use the phrase replacement. And what did she just call it? Replacement theory? I recommend calling it white erasure. That has premises in it that empower you, empower the people you hear. Replacement is associated in our lives with all things good. We replace things that need to be replaced.
Ideology, it's basically the idea.
And which is why anti-whites love using it.
The idea that whites are gradually replaced by non-whites.
Don't get your feathers ruffled. Of course, they're going to say that's not happening. That sort of gaslighting is meant to make you become like this unthinking responder to what they're saying. Don't fall into that trap.
This is inherently.
Look at that. Isn't this beautiful? That is magnificent. Look at the flags are out. Everything is peaceful and proud in that glorious setting there. Wonderful country.
A very dangerous conspiracy theory. They even have a countdown on their website.
So, and that's another thing. Replacement theory and the other one, they both are able to dismiss them and make you seem crazy by just saying it's a conspiracy theory. But when you say white erasure, every white person you talk to has seen that in their lives and they see it everywhere. So when the anti-whites say, oh, white erasure is not happening, all of that power that they're using, she's talking to everyone watching Channel 4. If she were saying white erasure isn't happening, every person watching Channel 4 is going to say, oh, are you kidding? But when she says replacement theory, the viewer doesn't know what all is associated with this replacement theory. Are there other many thoughts, many ideas associated with it?
Counts the days until they believe the UK will have more non-whites than whites.
Patriotic Alternatives say this is a fact, not a conspiracy theory.
They're the windmills. They ruin it. Don't they ruin it? The countryside.
After months of building an online backstory, Elliot receives an invite to a PA hike.
So listen to that again. Months of developing backstory. By the way, though, he came, according to Sam, he showed up, said he was a construction worker, but he didn't have any muscles. We don't need to be like always on the qui vive for evidence of everybody's claims. But if something really stands out, you know, if a guy shows up and he says he shucks corn for a living and has no arms, you know, we should probably pay close attention to that one.
One of the group's many rambles in Britain's countryside.
It's just absolutely beautiful. I've got some footage of the
and part of PA's respectable face.
We
you do everything above board.
Look at this. And it's part of their respectable face, of course, implying that there's something very ugly. The whole thing is biased from start to finish. And there's nothing there's nothing fair. There's nothing impartial about these anti-whites. Journalism is a fraud. And what we need to do is not just complain about it, but we need to establish our norms, our presence, our projection in such a way that when the anti-whites do what we know they're always going to do, they relate with their hundreds of thousands of dollars that they spent on this and the millions of dollars and millions they put into television and advertising and everything, that they then end up using that power to relate to our brothers and sisters exactly what we want them to relate.
You know, we have a code
in spite of themselves.
No racial slurs, no encouragement of violence, no threatening people.
Okay, so you see what they did right there? They said, this is part of the respectable face. And then they're talking about how they have this code of conduct. They play lore talking about the code of conduct as though this is just some sort of facade rather than who PA really is. Folks, I got to drive it home again and again. You have to be the hero in our story, not the villain in theirs. There's a code of conduct, not because it's a facade at PA, but because they don't want folks coming in there, for one, anti-whites coming in and saying a bunch of ugly things and recording it. And for two, because so many of our people are so beaten down and so infected with meme pathogens that they think resistance to anti-whiteism is to play the villain in their story, which is to be ugly and say ugly things. And so you have to put your foot down somewhere.
The hike is organized by some of PA's top-ranking members.
Oh, hiya.
Hi.
I'm Laura.
Including Deputy Leader Laura Towler. And her partner, PA Yorkshire's regional organizer, James Baker.
I love that they called him that in an attempt to dox him, but that's not his name.
Elliot's surprised to find that children are welcome.
Surprised to find that they're, of course, every sentence is crafted to demonize. So like, there are supposed to be gargoyles there because it's a PA event. There are gargoyles. Children are allowed? Won't they be eaten? Oh my God. Another reason why you have to be normal. You have to have the normal sensibilities. You have to let that shine through. Your normal sensibilities have to be allowed to shine through. Forget about this. You have somebody in your group that, and this was the norm back before the internet, somebody in the group and they want to act exceedingly ugly. They want to recommend evil things, criminal things. Then you say to them, this is your only chance. You do it one more time and you have to go.
PA says they don't condone racist language, but is this policy adhered to by its senior figures?
No. Never use the racism is an anti-white slur that means the person or the thing that it is referencing is not anti-white enough. Make sure you share that with everybody.
When you place after trying to watch my P's and Q's for the last like year out, Aldi, it's like the second day we're in Nottingham and it's just like, back to this.
Yeah, I think what was happening during this conversation and what was relayed during PWR is that you're in these environments and you feel like, well, I'm relaxed enough to quote somebody else, to say what somebody else said. And like, first of all, it's English is our language. When it comes right down to it, we will fucking decide what words can and cannot be said. You want to decide? Get your own language. All right? You want to decide what's said in Hebrew or Swahili or whatever it is? Fine. But it's a great example here where even if you think, well, I'm just going to quote somebody else, I'm gonna tell you what somebody else said and in the quote what they actually said, because we're actual adults here. We could say a word with knowing that this is not something that we're going to use in our normal speech, but you have to be cognizant.
Over time, Elliot appears to gain the trust of Patriotic Alternative.
Of course, because they're normal people.
How are you?
Today, he's been invited to help with leafleting in Hull.
My gosh, how demonic.
To peddle COVID conspiracies.
Well, did it take away people's freedom? I mean, these things are objectively, some would say they're objectively true. I'm asking you, I don't know.
About where to leaflet. He's consulted a former member of the far-right British National Party.
Okay, here they go there. They're also, this is the guilt by association. Never allow them to set cleave us into pieces by guilt by association. It is divide and conquer.
Yeah, so he was saying that this estate, apparently it was really good for the BNP. So it's like, all right, cool, we'll hit there.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah.
You know, like, somebody who comes to white well-being, that, I mean, clearly you have to give up all of the ugliness of the past, all of the ugliness baggage that you have kept. You have to, this is about being, coming to white well-being is about being redeemed.
No point doing areas, as you should have put it in the
thing. Well, that's the thing, it's like, he was saying, it's like, there was some area I was looking at, and I was like, oh, it could be good for leafing, and it's like, Asian area.
So he doesn't want to go deliver leaflets in a non-white area, and this is why I prefer just saying non-white. There's nothing offensive, of course, about just means you're not white, because you don't, he's sounds to me like he's looking out for these non-white people, doesn't want to accidentally scare them, because they're going to be reading into a leaflet that could just have a big heart on it. They're going to be reading into it every fictional television show and movie they've ever seen and thinking, oh, are they going to come storm the house right now? That's not Sam's fault or PA's fault, but in fact it is to their honor that they don't want to get to these folks with these leaflets. They want to get to our brothers and sisters.
It's horrible, man. It's too getting escorted out by the police. That would be cool.
PA town now, bitch.
During,
I can't, of course, what they're saying, I can't totally make out, so I can't speak to.
Elliot's time with PA, he visits some of the most deprived parts of England.
It's like the poor areas, you know.
Yeah.
They pick predominantly white areas of multicultural towns and cities.
Of course.
In his house earlier, and he's like, my missus is half caste. And I was like, I want to go. It's like, it's not the term we use now, mate. but yeah, he was like, of course, it's racist shit, and like, threw it at me.
But PA's hateful messages aren't just being heard on the streets.
Of course, if you threw anything at a anti-white, that even a piece of paper, that would be assault.
To a new, younger audience online.
And here it goes. They're coming after your children.
PA's,
don't you see this?
Is Mark Collett.
This is Mark when he's 20 years old.
Of the far right party, the BNP.
So he made some decisions back then, like most people. You see it here. You make some decisions that are evidence of the anti-white narrative. It's evidence that our people are taught that if they're going to stand up and attempt to defend us because of their concern for what's happening to our people, the victimization of our people, that they have to get a certain haircut, they have to get a certain dress, they have to get a certain set of clothes, boots, and all of this sort of nonsense. This is what I've talked about, anti-white theater. Well, as you can see, Mark is not a member of anti-white theater anymore. He doesn't want to be the villain in their story.
Millions of views.
Hello, everybody.
In lockdown, Collett hosts gaming nights attended by teenagers. Public live streams of warfare games.
Well, you mean the most popular games there are that teenagers might play?
There is also
this is what they're playing anyhow.
My previous work on
billions of dollars.
Patriotic Alternative
in
are
profit.
Targeting children online.
There you have them actually saying that. They're targeting children.
Attempting to use videos, memes, and other ways.
You know, right after they're showing you crosshairs No mistake there. This is how the anti-whites, they're savvy. They know what they're doing.
Radicalize and recruit.
This is why we have to use
young people to their cause.
A real life, we have to view it as a real life chess game. You know, she just used grooming. You got to love that. Let them use grooming all they want. You want to talk about pedo grooming? Call it pedo grooming.
It's going to be the future for us.
Barclay Walsh is one of PA's youngest members. He started following leader Collett when he was just 13 years old. Walsh is a so-called Zoomer nationalist, a Gen Z recruit drawn to the far right online.
The Muslims, brother. Muslim.
He now produces his own offensive material.
His own offensive material. He now produces his own offensive material.
Including this chat show, live streamed on PA's YouTube channel.
You know, you don't see us in advertising anymore, these mixed-race couples. It's all white erasure at the end of the day.
Yes.
We are increasing.
Yes! It's all white erasure at the end of the day. I think Barclay is the hero of this expose. I think he's going to go places. Didn't he also use anti-whiteism?
Seeing more young people being drawn into far-right extremism. We have seen how children have gone on to commit acts of violence. In some cases, they've been drawn into terrorism. Although PA...
How about some evidence? They could just make these claims, but it's not what actually happened in the real world. It's what's happened in fiction, my friends. And so, therefore, it did happen. Remember how the human brain works.
Terrorism, the fact that they are promoting the same ideology, the same dangerous anti-minority narratives as it...
And the use of the word minority as a mean pathogen there, we never use it. They're non-whites. They are not in some precarious position.
Extreme right-wing terrorists. They are fundamentally helping to create a climate that is conducive to terrorism and violence. The law at the moment in this country...
Abject lies.
...is not adequate to deal with hateful extremism.
And look at how lovely this thing is right here, this anti-white. My goodness. All you young guys out there that may have come across some of your father's Playboys, maybe you hear mom walking up the hallway, just have this image on hand. And you'll be fine. You'll be standing straight up. There'll be no problems.
Groups like Patriotic Alternative.
Undercover reporter Elliot learns that Walsh was arrested by police for handing out PA leaflets on his way to school. He was never charged.
He said he was
online,
not on his way to school.
PA's leaders give him their full support.
How are you doing?
Despite everything, I'm doing very well. Thank you, Mark.
We're very, very proud of you.
So the misrepresentation there of school is to imply that he's at school and he's spreading this material at school. Which, by the way, he should be.
Make sure you get a free ticket for the next conference, where you will definitely be introduced as a guest of honor for what you've been through.
We're always here for you if you need anything.
So you don't have... There'll be misrepresentations within the white sympathetic sphere about, and as there always are, about what we say here and what PA says. You're not concerned with this veneer. You are concerned with making sure that who and what we truly are, the heroes in our story, is channeled and projected out for our brothers and sisters to see, period. Doesn't matter what the anti-whites are always going to demonize us. Look at how wonderful Mark and Laura look there. They're always going to demonize. So you're not talking to them, though. You're talking to our brothers and sisters. What good do you think this did Channel 4 with them looking like that? Come on.
But news of Walsh's arrest soon spreads.
Obviously, everything with Barclay, I think people are bricking it out. Yeah. A lot of the Zoomers have all just run off.
And next time Elliot meets with PA, numbers are down.
Like, it might just be us.
Yeah, you'll get the news there. You'll get, if you participate with PA, you'll be physically attacked and there's no recourse. You had to get beat in, no recourse. You participate with PA, you get arrested. Everything they do, every sentence is meant to undermine white well-being, is meant to undermine the defense against anti-whiteism. Every sentence. Now, what do you think about these people at Channel 4?
It's just Elliot and senior members Baker and Towler leafleting on the outskirts of Rotherham.
You mean the heroes? Okay.
Why have we chosen this area?
It's Rotherham. Yeah, but we're in the, an outskirts that is heavily white, heavily working class.
Are we still...
They think they're alone.
Are you still watching
today,
on YouTube?
Others are watching.
Still working?
A masked group confronts them.
No.
And they also go for Elliot.
Listen.
Okay, so there you have it.
I'm an undercover journalist.
I'm a journalist. Undercover journalist. What a coward. So they get her side by side. You'll get arrested. You'll get physically attacked. And this is how scary it is for you. I mean, him terrified and running away is great for the objective of these anti-whites, to convey to folks, this is how horrifying it is to participate with PA.
He follows our protocols and heads to a nearby backup car.
Yeah, I've been attacked. Some guys.
Being attacked.
Guys with masks on. Three of them. Yeah, I'm nearly there.
And they're giving you all of, why are they showing you this? For the reason I just said. That's why they're showing you all of that information. Him breathless, him making his way to the backup car. This is what happens when you pass out leaflets with PA. Despicable.
PA blamed the attack on far left anti-fascists.
Oh, PA blames the attack. Might not be right because we just know that they're all liars, right? And the cowards also, this woman doing the voiceover and everybody participating and paying for this filth. They just claim it was, well, we know from everything she has said so far that they're just a bunch of liars.
So what happens?
Some guys just came out of nowhere and just...
I mean, how do we know that they were just some rival Nazi group?
Started swamping us, just hitting us.
Was it because you were leaving?
Yeah. We've only been doing this like 10 minutes. They must have known.
Right.
Yeah. Still, now they got the breathless driving away. He's being rescued.
Elliot's worried he's blown his cover.
Yeah, I'm worried that I've told him what I was. I just had to say to him, look, I'm an undercover journalist. It's the only thing I can think to say to stop this guy from punching me in the face. Turn this off.
It's the only thing I could say to stop them from punching me in the face. You little bitch. Little bitch. All right. We're going to jump forward now. The enemy within.
Five-star reviews. Last for 20.
I don't want any of these commercials.
After the violent
attack. Just so everybody knows. After the attack.
Elliot's worried PA overheard his admission.
You mean his squeal, like a pig. That's what it sounded like to me. Wee! 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 That's what it sounded like to me, Elliot.
Nothing. You all right?
He needs to go find God, or he needs to go find a gym, or he needs to go find... This guy is such a... Was he white? I mean, all you get to see is that he's a neck beard.
Yeah, definitely.
It's PA's Christmas party in an industrial estate near Wetherby. To Elliot.
Elliot thought that, and by the way, they're going to a Christmas party here where everything is, you know, normal. I haven't seen this part of it. We'll keep going, though. But he was worried that when he was squealing like a piglet running away, that Sam and Laura, a woman... we're busy listening to what his squeals were while they were getting physically attacked.
Surprise, the attack actually seems to have earned him points.
He's surprised.
Yeah.
Although Elliot's camera fails, Collett's racist views are captured on audio.
So anti-white slur.
With the nationalists a couple of years back, and I said I don't like those pit bull breeds. You know, they're bred for violence. You shouldn't leave your kid with them. He said, no, mate. It's not about the breed. It's about the way you bring them up. I said, does that account for black people too? Shut up.
As the party ends.
Okay, so I couldn't exactly hear exactly what was said there, but sounded like he was talking about biospirit, ultimately, that different races have different instincts. And that, of course, is immoral in the anti-white narrative to hold such a position. Because ultimately, in the anti-white position, everybody's the same except with different paint jobs. And even though we're the same, white people are evil. And white people have harmed more people, and white people have stolen more, and non-white people can dance better, and non-white people are more moral, and non-white people are more in touch with the universe and nature. And non-white, I mean, this is what we learn from babyhood all the way to the grave. And so Mark making a reference to a difference between the different races of man is, of course, to be in violation of the anti-white narrative.
PA are looking to the future.
You can talk online all you want, but it's trust in the community.
And by the way, for those who are listening for the first time, biospirit instinct of mankind, there isn't one better than the other. There's no cosmic measuring stick for which race of people have a better biospirit. It's just instinct, and it manifests itself the way it does in our cultures and the way we live and our norms, etc. No one is better than any other. Unlike the anti-white narrative, where they say all of us are the same, except non-whites are better and white people are worse.
That brings us two together. It's a foundation that allows us to secure the existence of our people and the future for white children.
Cheers.
Wow, so they have nothing to show. Wait a second, where are all the guys that
another
are like
year,
shouting
and
marching around like waterfowl?
Unless
where is that? No, if you were doing that, you better believe they would be showing that.
Elliot's,
and then what would that do to our brothers and sisters that see it?
Social gathering rules. PA used the hike to publicize their politics. In the presence of young children, they display an anti-immigrant banner.
Oh, okay, so you see how the anti-whites view this. So this is a statement of our love for our people, our countries that we create. And to an anti-white, I want you to note, this is the kind of thing you talk with granny about, you talk with your mom about. To an anti-white, you are harming a non-white person by caring about white well-being. What does that mean? This is what I figured out in junior high school. Read Crucible, my book Crucible, if you don't know. What did I figure out? 11 to 13 years of age, I figured out that if it was immoral to care about white well-being, the opposite morality is white ill-being. Don't you see that, Granny? That the only way I can be good in this narrative is to victimize my own kind, to white erase everything my people have ever done. That's the only thing that's moral in this system. What does that tell you about this bitch doing the voiceover? What does that tell you about the producers? What does that tell you about this neckbeard? It's immoral if you care about white well-being. It's only moral if you care about white ill-being, if you effectuate white ill-being.
One of the positives has actually come out of this lockdown.
With children stuck at home, PA takes to promoting homeschooling.
We want to help people out of the left-wing, liberal, establishment educational system.
I want you all to do this, by the way.
They have a template.
Take the URL for this,
for parents to withdraw children
this review
from school.
Of this
and an alternative
nonsense,
curriculum,
this expose, anti-white expose. And I want you to attach it to the tweet
portray white
that
that
Andy, what is his last name, NGO,
this is a curriculum that
he made a tweet about this, and it's rolling big time on Twitter. Attach this to that tweet.
Ideologies. They are trying to indoctrinate the younger generations in order to have a longer term political impact.
Oh, really? So they're telling white children, hey, the world's going to be pretty miserable for our people, and that means you, since you're a member of it. Remember that, white folk. You are attacked as an individual because you are a member of a people that is being attacked. There's no way out of it for you. You can be anti-white all you want now and gain a tiny bit of a reprieve, but it won't last. It's certainly not going to last if you're young. It's not going to last for you. And at any age, what if you have children, grandchildren? Definitely not for them.
Parents should be offered ways to educate their children free of material that intends to inflict anti-white.
Oh, I love it. I love it. Say it again, folks. Let's get some raucous emojis going. Parents should be offered ways to educate. This is what the anti-white reporters are having to say. We put those words in their mouth. How many times do I have to be proven right? Over two decades of work. And have so many people saying, no, it can't work, Jason. No, I got them saying the words I want them to say. Tell me it doesn't work.
They added, we make no apologies for the banners. And that lockdown regulations were unconstitutional.
Amen.
Patriotic Alternative intends to win power in order to be a movement that reaches out effectively to normal people.
And that is being done because these are normal people.
PA's political ambitions hit a stumbling block.
Unfortunately, we have been rejected by the Electoral Commission.
Their application to become a political party is rejected. And PA's members are feeling the heat too. Online, their true identities are being outed.
Yeah, that's... And why is that an issue? Well, that's an issue because the world is anti-white, right? You can't get your party registered as a party. Why? Because you're going to get in the way of anti-whiteism. What does that demonstrate when you talk about that? What does it demonstrate when you talk about being doxxed by these anti-white bastards? It demonstrates that the anti-white narrative that the white man is in charge for the benefit of the white man is hogwash. That's why you talk about these sorts of things from this angle. You don't even have to openly say that. Your audience will put two and two together. It's about limiting the outcomes to the truth rather than allowing them to go down these circuitous routes that the anti-whites want them on.
Deputy leader Laura Towler is actually called Laura Tyree. As for PA Yorkshire's James Baker, he's Sam Mellier.
Can you believe, once again, let's go back to earlier in this program. They clearly demonstrate by this neckbeard screaming out, I'm one of you. I'm just undercover. I'm one of you. They clearly demonstrate the people at Channel 4 making the big money, the woman, this bitch doing the voiceover, that they know when they dox these folks, they know that they are sending a signal to those anti-whites in the streets who wear the balaclavas to come and maim them. Does that not make them responsible? Just as responsible as the people who hit them over the head? I guarantee you, if I or Sam or somebody were to say, hey, this is where this woman doing this voiceover, this is where she lives, this is where you can find her, this is where you can find where her husband works, this is where you can find where she goes. You better believe that if anybody went and hurt her, that we would be charged. My friends, I tell you, the anti-whites control the courts. They control the government. No white man is in charge of any of this for the benefit of the white man. Anti-whites everywhere. And even though there is no legitimate court system out there that will come and arrest this bitch and everybody at Channel 4 who participated in this, the blood of every injury, the damage of every piece of property destroyed by anti-whites is as much their fault as those who commit the acts. Because this is the beginning of that commission.
And under that name,
sickening.
He has history with the far right.
Oh, he's got history with the far
right.
In
November 2016,
guilt by association.
Mellier attended a demonstration alongside National Action, a far-right group whose views were so extreme, they were banned soon after.
National Action was a...
That says nothing about where Sam was and what he thought. Very likely, there you go, using this footage. Is that
many of their own members were involved in really extreme violence.
Is that Sam actually doing that or not? And even if they did have Sam doing that and he had done it, march around like an idiot. People grow and they develop. And when they begin standing up for white well-being, they think this is the way you behave. No, this is not the way you behave.
Some of its key players, including leader Christopher Lithgow and strategist Mark Jones. Both are serving prison sentences for their involvement in National Action.
Okay, lesson learned, right, folks? Lesson learned, right? Do you have to get arrested and spend the rest of your life or a giant chunk of it in jail? Where you might get raped, where you might get maimed, where you might get whatever. Do you have to? Or can you see? Wow. You know what? Maybe what Jason's been arguing about for over two decades about not playing the villain, maybe that is the smart thing to do. Because instead of having your life ruined, you can go the direction of like Sam and Laura, where they have a wonderful little family they're growing and they are gonna blossom. That's what we want for everybody, to be who we really are, the heroes in our story. Rather than think, well, the way to stand up is to dress up like a jackbooted idiot and let me look in their playbook. What am I supposed to talk like?
As well as Melia, PA has allowed at least two former associates of National Action into their ranks.
Former National Action activists.
People growing
PA
and developing and leaving stupidity behind. Activists. Leaving ugly focuses behind because those focuses were not theirs just found a new at all. Perhaps those focuses were not theirs in the beginning. Those focuses were not of their own creation. Those focuses were given them by anti-whites.
And say the film's
like
experts'
that
opinions are
neck there that threw up a
biased
face that was just talking a moment ago.
Sam Melia provided no comment. He has previously denied ever being involved with National Action. It's the run-up to the by-election.
Oh, so Sammy showed up at one of these events and that's it.
Cox's
now they're going to say he's one of them.
Is up for grabs. PA can't compete as a political party.
Question Everything said LMAO, he has the Ukrainian Azov on his t-shirt. Who did? One
of
the guys?
Thousands of fake Labour leaflets are posted.
Where's the chin on this neck beard?
They appear.
He's got no chin.
By the Trade Union Congress. And show Keir Starmer taking the knee. The leaflets attract headlines, but no one claims responsibility.
Oh, so you're just going to attribute it to PA?
Dispatches can now reveal it was PA and leader Collett who were behind the leaflets.
Spoof leaflets.
Sam Melia discloses their aim. To turn white voters away from Labour.
So? Are they not allowed to participate in politics?
After the leafleting, PA
how dare
celebrate
they
their meddling in a private Telegram group.
Oh, they celebrate. They're meddling.
Deputy Leader Towler.
Don't you know that you're not allowed to participate in politics if you're not anti-white? It's
days
meddling.
Later, Labour clinches victory.
That tell again. Talk to your granny about
winning
that.
By just a few hundred votes.
She won the seat where her sister Jo Cox was murdered 5 years ago.
It is totally illegal to put out a leaflet in the name of another organisation during an election. And it is incumbent on the authorities to really look into this and prosecute where the evidence exists.
And never participate in anything illegal.
Months later, PA tried to interfere in another by-election, mimicking the Conservatives in the constituency of murdered MP Sir David Amis.
And why is it that they don't
online,
automatically
they
assume
about
that
voters.
Participants of PA or whoever, why don't they automatically assume that that was their genuine sentiments at that moment when they created the leaflet and distributed
Elliot
it?
Been invited
I mean, if you can have a sentiment that
national
declares
gallery
that you are a different sex, then, you know, that you're a woman when you were born with a penis, then surely you can morph from one political persuasion to another.
Around 150 people from across Britain are descending on the Peak District.
Gosh, that's gorgeous, isn't it? Look at that. My goodness.
They've told the campsite owners they're a community group who help the homeless.
They do help the
For
homeless.
For this landmark event, Elliot takes backup. another undercover reporter.
Hi guys.
Another undercover reporter?
This is my friend Ellis. Hi, nice to meet you, man.
There's a second undercover reporter.
By PA security and set up camp. As usual, PA's code of conduct applies. It claims to prohibit racial slurs and the promotion of violence.
Or it claims to prohibit racial slurs.
It's the eve of the
final. But they say bad words. Somebody there said a bad word.
Denmark to get there.
You can sit around and talk about a victim. You could say that white people who care for white well-being are immoral, but that's fine. That's fine for the anti-white.
The group talks that's about not, that, shooting people.
That's not a slur.
Take the knee for Black Lives Matter.
When they're taking the knee, that's all right.
Yeah, they're complaining about
they
authorities taking the knee.
They even discuss the use of firearms.
Well, it doesn't matter if the loop becomes a little bit.
A bunch of guys sitting around a. At a camp talking about firearms.
Oh, that was lucky, wasn't it?
What a surprise. I mean, some of them might actually have interest in firearms.
The camp is attended by many people who defy the far-right stereotype, including someone who says he's a trainee teacher and a scouts volunteer, a regular PA member. He talks to others about the soap the Nazis made from the corpses of
Jews. Oh my God.
I hear that's one group.
My God. Is that true? See, you can't. This is the kind of thing. I gotta stop it for a second. That is disgusting. That is absolutely. Who the fuck does this guy think? Why would you talk about something like that? There's nothing funny. That's not funny. When we were meeting, and all those people who online would say, well, what's your problem you're going to be so dainty or whatever. When we were only meeting in person, anybody who talked like that was immediately thrown out. Immediately. That was the norm. That's wretched. No, I don't know this person. I don't know if that person is there to say such ugly things for the reporters. Do you know that for sure that they're not? That would be, in my mind, that's as likely for anti-whites to do as to hire balaclava-wearing imbeciles to come up and beat down the reporter and Sam and Laura. It's just as likely for them to have somebody show up and say something like this. And this is why, because white people were also, you know, we get so nervous about what others are going to think. And I just got to tell you what. Anybody shows up and they want to start talking about something this disgusting, right out of the playbook for what somebody sounds like when they object to anti-whiteism, everyone present needs to say, that's it. That one time, and now you got to get right in your heart. You don't focus on other groups of people. You focus on us and the love for our people. Everyone present says that. And then what happens? You engender this virtuous cycle that just gets better and more intelligent and accesses more and more of our brothers and sisters out there, their talents, their resources, for the good of our people, for the good of our children, for the good of our elderly, for the good of our robust, masculine, sex-powerful men like myself. Let somebody show up and talk like that. I tell you what, though, you know, ultimately, the guy talking this way could be one of those poor souls that decided, hey, I hate what's being done to my people. I'm going to put an end to it. And then looked out into the world of anti-white narrative and said, what am I supposed to say? Where am I supposed to focus? So if that guy is genuine, if he's not been inserted or paid to say this, for the video camera and the recording, then he needs to go free. He needs to be redeemed to love, hope, and redemption and give that filth up. That's my message to him. God, I had no idea that somebody's going to be saying something that dumb. I would be livid.
How would you wash yourself with people you consider disgusting?
Yeah, it's disgusting to even talk about it.
As the day wears on, our reporters encounter yet more anti-Semitism, including from a law student in his early 20s.
Exactly, folks. This is same thing. Do you hear the difference? Are you learning? Do you hear the difference? Now, Mark would Laura absolutely would lay them out. You can't control what every single person is going to be saying, obviously, but that's why you set up a standard of behavior. And that's one of the reasons why, because I have a standard of behavior, focus on us rather than focus on this other group of human beings. I'm going to focus on them, and all the energy you're putting toward them is not energy you're putting toward us. All the energy you're putting to how awful you think they were and talking about how awful you think they were or are is not energy of love you're putting toward us. You see the big difference? I've been coming across this kind of stuff for many years now. And it is so obvious, the day and night difference. Folks need to go free. They need to be redeemed to love, hope, and redemption.
PA Zoomers flock to leader Collett, including teenage protege Barclay Walsh.
This could fuck Mark. All right, Mark.
Later, Walsh talks about his Jewish teacher.
She's got Hebrew tattoo on her arm. I thought they marked them with numbers, personally. Right, good about luck. That's going to my PA speech.
So he has a Jewish teacher who can express pride in his race. Good for him. Can Barclay express pride for his in that classroom? Or would that Jewish teacher be anti-white as well? And that's what matters to us, whether somebody is anti-white or not. Not what race they are, not what their immutable characteristic is. I would hope that this guy would allow Barclay to serve white well-being.
Led me to being at a campsite with some of the most notorious neo-Nazis in the country.
But this is also, I mean, Barclay was speaking to
Mark Collett, and Laura Towler told us that Patreon
making sort of this, and there are content creators out there who say these, who say ugly things to get a laugh because it's something that is not permitted. And the young people are always attracted to things that are not permitted by adults. But the problem is when you are, and this is where this starts for them, is that, oh, you mean adults don't like it? They're gonna freak out if I say it? Okay, I'll say it. That is simultaneously playing the villain in the anti-white narrative. You want to know what else they'll freak out about? You go into those teachers, you'll find out real quickly, the professors, which ones are anti-white and which ones aren't. The moment you start talking about white well-being, trust me, I know. Because when I started all the way back at 11, 12, 13 years of age, standing up for our people, I didn't say a single thing about any other race of man. Not a single thing. I talked about white well-being. And let me tell you what, those anti-whites came unglued. So if you want to see adults lose it, it's not racial epithets and what they want you to say. It's being white positive and advocating for white well-being. Then you'll see the biggest conniptions the world could produce.
Alternative is proud to advocate for the rights of the indigenous people of the British Isles and that it is our constitutional right to organize.
Yes.
They said PA activists engage in legal, democratic, and peaceful political activities.
Yes. What are you planning on taking those away?
Exploiting global events and the culture wars.
Oh, they're exploiting those things, of course.
To characterize persuading other people to join a cause through discussion or by presenting alternative ideas as grooming is completely outrageous. And that the program takes events out of context and misrepresents.
Of course it does.
Sam Mellier and Barclay Walsh did not respond to our allegations.
There is no good reason why we should allow
it's almost over, folks.
Hateful extremists.
And I'll see if you all said anything or financially gifted. There's no good reason what?
program takes events out of context and misrepresents. Sam Mellier and Barclay Walsh did not respond to our allegations.
There is no good reason why we should allow hateful extremist groups like PA to operate.
Why we should allow them.
Obligation on our parliament, on our government to outlaw the...
Look at this filthy anti-white POS. No good reason that we should allow them. Allow them. You see, this is what you get. Remember this, especially white ladies out there, when you were thinking, well, if we just, not all white ladies, but we're just thinking we need to be fair to them because it's this objective thing beyond us and we need to be beyond ourselves, because if we're not beyond ourselves in our virtues and our et cetera, if we're not beyond ourselves, then it's not fair for everybody. And smart people like me were saying all along, no, you dumbasses, as soon as they have you, all of that fair is going out the window. You cannot submit your well-being to ideas that you created. You do not sacrifice the body on the altar of the ideas that we envisioned. Our well-being has to come first. It is more important than the ideas we create. I cannot believe. Where are the so-called people who study the philosophers? Didn't they say that somewhere? How did this end up this bad? I guess you all have just been giving really great novel takes. This filthy anti-white here. User to kill a Woody.
Activity of groups like Patriotic Alternative. To not do so, I think, would be a failure.
That thing was beat with the ugly stick, as we say down south.
Next.
All right, that's that. All right, folks, let me see what you were saying. I'm going to turn this music off. Boy, it was tough to think with that playing in the background. My God. I don't know how loud it was for you all, but it was pretty loud for me. All right, we're blank over here on entropy. And we have this tweet that I mentioned. I don't know if we'll show that or not, because then that'll just be another opportunity to put a strike on the channel. See what you all are saying over here. Yes, very bitter over there, Iron Will, talking about these people. Popcorn Power saying, what if the sign was, we will not be erased? Which sign specifically? I would put white erased, because that, if you're not seen with it, if there's no other context, then at least the viewer has a chance to figure out what group. Battle Cat over here on DLive, hello to you. Battlecat says, white erasure. I'll use that going forward. There is no room for misinterpretation, and it loses the theory part. Yeah, get rid of the theory. Exactly. We got to empower ourselves. Remember, we don't control the media. We don't get to, we can go home and lament and say a million times in our head, this is what we really mean. But that does not reach, not, we don't telepathically reach out to our brothers and sisters. So with that moment that we have, bam, we got to hit them with something truthful and loving so that when they go home, they're empowered by it and they want to share it. All right, we're going to get ready to drop out of here, folks. Let me take a look over at... make sure we're blank on Cash App and didn't miss anybody's financial gifts. All right, we are blank over there. Xanth says, they picture her in a room full of books to convey a learned, intelligent person. Wonderful observation, my friend, yes. But she's never read any of them and is daft enough to have no self-awareness. Very well stated. Precisely. That is exactly why they put her in such room. There's no mistakes in that. The whole thing was crafted. The whole thing was crafted to undermine resistance to anti-whiteism. Call it that, folks. Anti-whiteism. In Going Free, my book, Go Free, I talk about how I had to reinvent that word because I didn't know it existed. Nobody was using anti-white and anti-whiteism. But then we found it was years later that that anti-white started getting used by one of the courageous groups in the U.S. For that, we're very happy that they did. And then we find out that in a 50-year-old dictionary, anti-white and anti-whiteism were both present. Both of them. And then the anti-whites took them out of the dictionary. Why is that? Because if you don't have the concepts to defend yourself, you cannot defend yourself. Let me scroll up. It is called anti-whiteism. Feminism, subset of anti-whiteism. Marxism, subset of anti-whiteism. Economic Marxism, subset of anti-whiteism. Just call it anti-whiteism. Nordic Warrior is with us. Great to see you, brother. Peter is with us. Hello to you. James is with us. Brad C. asked about the background music that I was playing. Yeah, you couldn't actually hear in their expose, their piss-poor attempt at an expose, which is what it was. I mean, let's be serious. This was a hit piece on PA to demonize those who stand up against anti-whiteism. And I think on some levels, they did a good job. They will have scared people away, regrettably. But I played background music over their scary music to help legitimize my fair use review of their material. Because rest assured, those POSs will be reaching out to YouTube. Bain says, absolute coward. The infiltrator cannot be committed to the infiltration to gain trust. A total worm. Yeah. Caleb's here. Grim is here. Never felt guilty. Great to see you all. Thanks for showing up. Serge is here. Fit and Healthy saying hello. I maybe just showed up. Simon JJ, Kingdom of Inland, Rock Shot 100. If you're not on Twitter, then don't worry about it. Andy Neo, how is that name pronounced? How does he want it pronounced? Pro bono. All right, we're about to wrap it up. It was great to have you all join me. No guilt, only pride. Please share the work that we're doing. And the anti-whites, folks, shadow ban me to no end. And smart anti-whites, in the very beginning, if you all remember, before they started shadow banning and the banning at the level that it is now, governments of Europe, not the European Union or not any of these other entities, because they did it one at a time. Governments of Europe banned my channel from reaching the populations. And then when YouTube went through that big changeover, something broke and I suddenly reached everybody in those countries again. And I guess it didn't matter because they shadow banned the hell out of it. You have to share it. You have to talk about the work that we're doing. Smart anti-whites can see that this is going to appeal to our brothers and sisters. Going Free will appeal to our brothers and sisters. Ordinary people who are working for a living and who want to see a future for their children. This appeals to them. Donning Armor is here. Great to see you. Streaky Bacon, hello to you. John Blaze. Fit and Healthy at Any Age says, love for our people is always stronger than hate for others. Amen to that. Rockshot Jason, can I love you? And I am a dude. I don't love you like that. Yes, you can love me in the way that you are sharing. Thank you. Reptile says, never seen any PA representative or outreach member in a balaclava. Are these anti-white imposters attempting to misrepresent and vilify our brothers? Were there people wearing? I didn't see that. I mean, there were anti-whites that attacked them in the street. They were wearing balaclavas. Okay, his name. Thank you, Brad. His name is just No. That's how he wants it pronounced. All right. Andy No. But today we're going to say Andy Yes. Get on over to Twitter if you're on. Attach this review to that tweet that is his tweet on the PA expose hit piece, please. Rory says, by the way, that Sarah Khan at the end of the video was the same woman who a couple of years ago put a recommendation before Parliament that PA be banned for hateful extremism. Okay, well, she's a villainous anti-white bitch. What a surprise. So the only thing to Sarah Khan that is moral is white ill being. You have to be harming white people. Brad C says, excellent show, Jason. I deeply appreciate that, brother. Thank you so much. Eric is with us. Hello and welcome. We're just about to sign out. Roll out, I should say. Oh, over here, we have Popcorn Power says, it's also pronounced No, but today it's Andy Yes. Let's make sure, I'll attach this video too. Let's make sure to get it out there to as many people as we can so that we can make a difference in the world with a practice that works. And with that, I will say, let's go free and roll out.